Hello, Doctor and everyone. It's Olivia. Today, I'd like to share something about non-linguistic features of social media. And I'd like to introduce Weibo. Weibo is the hottest social media in China. It's very popular in China, like Chinese Twitter. Users can share text, pictures, and videos in Weibo. It's a UGC platform, user-generated content platform. In real life, people's conversations often include changes in tone of voice and body language to express emotions. In addition to the content of the conversation itself, based on this paper, in Chinese social media, the researchers found that in addition to the expression of positive and negative emotions, people tend to express a kind of humorous emotion. The blog posted by Weibo users contain a large number of emoticons, which are often difficult to categorize as positive or negative humorous emotions. Some emoticons are simply meant to be funny or joking, and they express a subtle humorous characteristic of Chinese culture. Again, from this paper, there are 14 emoticons which contain adverse, positive, or negative emotions in this part. Besides, there are 23 emoticons which be considered humorous emotions rather than positive or negative emotions. And for example, I posted one blog, good luck. It's very simple words, sentence, good luck, just two words. But with the A1 emoticon, that could be sarcasm and that not friendly. And simply good luck with the emoticon H2. This one, a guy with a sticker with heart. That would be sincere wishes, like I say good luck to you, very friendly and from my heart. Number three, good luck with the emoticon F3. This one, can you see that? F3. And a guy with the glasses and who is covering his or her mouth with hand. That would be very vague, because you can't see the currently emotion face. So he or she, who the blogger can explain it positively or negatively, because it's totally up to the one who posted the blog. So the more familiar we are with these emoticons and the different contexts in which they are used, the more accurately we can determine the authors or all the Weibo users' true purposes in the conversations of Weibo. So that's what I want to share. Thank you very much.